rehab exercises are equally important and sometimes even more important than training itself. If you do not perform rehab exercises after you finish your training, it is the same thing as not completing your workout. You cannot expect to increase the intensity of your training or progress consistently if you do not apply rehab exercises at the end of every training session. Now, how much time should you spend on rehab exercises? The answer to that question is 1/3 of the time you spend working out. So if your workout lasts 3 hours, you must spend at least 1 hour dedicated to rehab exercises. And if you work out for 1 hour, your rehab should be approximately 20 minutes. In today's tutorial, we're gonna demonstrate a series of rehab exercises using 4 different sets of equipment. The first category is gonna be the rolling exercises using the foam roller. The second category is gonna be the rehab exercises using the yoga blocks. The third category is gonna be the trigger point releasing exercises using this double-sided trigger point ball that we have. So without further ado, let's begin with the first category, with the foam rolling exercises using the foam roller. Let's mention a couple of facts about the foam roller. First, let's talk about the ridges of the foam roller. The ridges are these uneven shapes and lines that are in the foam roller. If the foam roller is flat, it means that there is less tension placed onto your muscles. If the foam roller is like this, with ridges, it means that the foam roller is capable of getting deeper into your muscle fibers. Hence, your foam rolling experience will be with increased pain levels. So if you're foam rolling for the first time, make sure that you use a roller without any ridges. If you're an advanced athlete, it means that potentially you will have a lot more tension trapped within your muscles. This means that you will need a much stronger foam roller with ridges just like this one. Now let's get into the foam rolling exercises. So if you have never used the foam roller before, be aware that it's gonna be a lot of tension being placed in your posterior chain, meaning your entire back. With the foam roller, we're able to target our lower back up until our neck area, including our shoulders. And as a beginner, you want to start placing as less tension as possible onto your muscles. And also a beginner would want to use a flat foam roller and not the one with ridges. So there are 4 levels of intensity the foam roller will produce. So you want to place the foam roller on your upper back. Make sure that your hands are staying by your sides. Squeeze your glutes in order to lift your hips. And now you want to roll back and forward using your heels. So it looks like this. Bodysthenics. For level 1, do not let the roller pass the mid part of your back. Also, do not let your hips touch the ground and try to create a smooth motion through your heels. Level 2. If you want to place an extra bit of tension and roll a bigger portion of your back, leading from your traps all the way to your lower back, this is how we're going to do it. Lift through your hips once again. You're going to engage your core this time so your back does not arch, and this time you're going to roll from your neck area all the way down to your lower back. Ensure that you're fully extending your knees, so that way the roller covers the entire part of your back. Now let's move on to level 3 foam rolling technique. Here we're going to implement the interlocking hand technique, whereby we're going to roll our entire back plus our deltoid muscles. Interlock your hands, lock your elbows out straight and place your hands in an overhead position. Lift your hips again and once again move through your heels to cover the entire range of motion up to your neck. You will notice that this time the foam roller will come in direct contact with your shoulder muscles.
Bodysthenics.
Now let's move to level 4 foam rolling, but only move to this final level if the first 3 levels are no longer painful. This time we're going to lay on the foam roller on our side by placing the roller directly on our lats. Keep your bottom arm extended out and your top arm to your chest. Make sure your body is tilted sidewards, and now we're rolling our posterior deltoid and latissimus dorsi muscle. Once again, ensure that our hips are off the ground and that you're initiating the movement through your heels. We'll be right back. benefit of this rehab tool is to get into those hard-to-reach areas where other tools cannot reach. You can use the rehab ball before and after, or even during your training. And I'd like to point out that beginners using the rehabilitation ball will spend much less time than what an advanced athlete would. An advanced athlete would potentially have a lot of tension in the forearms due to the increased time of his workout. So this is a handy tool to use in between intense sets. The first exercise we will demonstrate is how to release the tension from our forearms. So firstly, we want to find the hard surface to place the trigger point ball. Then we want to place the ball on our forearms and keep our supporting arm just under our elbow. And the reason we do this is because we want to take as much pressure off our elbow and place it into our forearm. From here, we want to start pushing our entire body weight forward and make sure that we relax our arm. By relaxing our arm, we ensure that the ball is going deep into our muscle tissue. We can also slowly start to roll side to side.
Bodysthenics.
It's very important that when we roll our arms, that we always roll across our muscle fibers and never in the same line as they are inserted. And the reason is that often when injuries take place, they often occur due to an overextension of your muscles or because your muscles are too tight. So you do not want to roll in the same direction in which your injury took place. Instead, you want to roll your tissues in a cross direction. This will help aid the recovery process of your muscles and also bring blood flow in the area which you are targeting. We can also use another effective trigger point exercise where we target our chest and shoulders, specifically our pec minor and parts of our front delt. Pec minor rehab ball. This exercise is very effective for athletes who have rounded shoulders and for those who are experiencing tightness in the upper chest area. It's also a very effective exercise to release tension from the point of where the chest meets the shoulder. This will increase the range of motion of your shoulder immediately. Place the rehabilitation ball on the wall and lean onto the ball, but make sure that the ball is placed in between your chest and the beginning of your shoulder. In other words, onto your pec minor. Relax your shoulder and chest as much as you can and lean forward onto the rehab ball. At this point, if you are tight in that area, you will feel quite a bit of pain. If you keep leaning forward and relaxing, you will notice the pain decrease. Once that pain decreases, you can start rolling side to side. You will then notice pain start to appear in other areas around your front delt and chest connecting point. Advanced athletes should spend approximately 1 to 2 minutes on each shoulder at the end of training, and for beginners, no longer than 30 seconds. Scapular rehab ball. The rehab ball is also useful for releasing tension from areas around your scapula, specifically between your scapula and your spine, and also below your scapula. It's very important to place the ball in the correct area. Do not place the ball directly on your spine or your scapula bone. The areas which you want to focus on are along the rhomboid muscles coming down around your scapula. You can also target the bottom part of your trap muscles. You can do this exercise standing or you can also perform it on the floor. Start off on a wall and if you want a deeper trigger point release, you can later on perform it on the floor. Begin by placing the ball onto the muscle groups between your scapula bone and your spine. Slowly lean back onto the ball, relax your entire upper body and allow the ball to sink deep into your muscles. Once that first pain barrier has decreased, you can begin to gently roll up and down and in short range of motions, side to side.
Bodysthenics.
Exercise with the rehab ball is a hip immobilization exercise which releases tension from your entire hip area. Over time, from performing a lot of full body exercises such as statics like the front lever and planche, hip muscles like the adductors and hip flexors get very tight and as a result, tension builds in the hips. You can use the rehab ball to release all that built up tension from your hips. Start by laying down flat on your stomach and place the rehab ball directly in the front part of your pelvis. But make sure to avoid your pelvic bone, but instead ensure that you feel the pressure of the ball on your hip flexors. Relax your entire body as much as possible, place your hands outwards to the side, tilt your head to the side and relax it on the floor, and allow the rehab ball to dig deep into your hip flexors to release the tension from your hips. Once again, hold this position until that initial pain decreases, and once it does, begin to roll side to side in small ranges of motion. It's recommended to do this exercise once a week, but the more often you do them, the less tension will be built up into your muscles. Now we're gonna show you guys a compilation of static and mobility stretches that you can incorporate at the end of each workout. It's also advised that you roll first and then stretch, so that way your muscles can stay nice and relaxed and can benefit more from the static stretching.
Bodysthenics. Bodysthenics. You can do this through Bodysthenics. Bodysthenics.
If you guys found value, then be sure to subscribe and also hit that bell icon for notifications. We upload a new tutorial every Wednesday and Saturday at 3 p.m. European Easter Summer Time. Before clicking out of this video, be sure to get your own wrist straps at bodysthenics.com. and to join our global family of athletes who are improving on a daily basis, send a direct message to management on Instagram today to join the first ever online calisthenics training portal.
Bodysthenics. You can do this through Bodysthenics.